You are my strength, my shield. We don't want to find our life in temporary things. This opportunity are saying, God will fight my life. Lord will fight me.
Today is the first Sunday of the three Sundays that God has given us as a special prayer.
pray in the name of Jesus that any power plan to make it your life, such power shall not matter. I say any power plan to make it your life, such power shall not matter. In the name of Jesus. Strange meetings going on in strange places to destroy your future shall scatter in the name of Jesus.
Satan presented himself before God
destroy your God. Such powers and entities shall not see the light of tomorrow in the name of Jesus. When you are talking about no evil shall befall you, do you know that accidents, calamities, challenges, failures, delay, sicknesses, infirmities, death, bondage, torture and torment, oppression, suppression and depression, heaviness and sorrow of the heart, rejection, unexplainable pains, loss of properties, demotion, spiritual pains, spiritual harassment, they are all associated with evil. And when all these demonic attributes appear, they make the life of someone become miserable. I decree by the power of the Lord that every weapon formed against you to destroy you. Such weapons are fire in the name of Jesus. Whosoever is planning to waste all your labor for brand, any man or woman, spirit powers or entities targeting the joy of your life, some powers shall die today in the name of Jesus. Do you know what? The enemies will not attack what is not valuable in your life. The enemies will not attack what is not giving joy. They will go for what is valuable. They will go for what is giving joy. They will go for that thing that is sick and that will become glorable. I pray, whosoever is attacking your honor, whosoever is attacking your peace, whosoever is attacking your children, whosoever is attacking your glory, shall die in the name of Jesus.
Secret place that can
sake of the Lord, not those who are not in Christ. So get some facts right. Let's continue. Surely, he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the mouth of the snare. Let's go. Who will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the mouth of the snare? God, when you are well, answer the child. It's not about going to church. Before people think, and when you go to church, you are saved. You can come to church, you will not be under the shadow of the Lord. You can go to church, you may be exposed to the demonic attacks. But when you have a personal encounter with God, it's not about my wife and my children. No. A man can be saved, and the family will not be saved. The wife can be saved, and the husband will not be saved. The children can be saved, the families will not be saved. Praise the Lord. Am I making sense?
Yes.
That's all. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wing shall thou trust. His truth shall be what? Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrows that fly by day, nor for the pestilence that walk with his hands, nor for the destruction that wish that I may. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. But it shall not come in at thee. One will not go down. That's it. Only with thy eyes shall thou behold and see the Lord of the living. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my record, even the most high that I petition. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come near thy dwelling. For he shall keep his angels shall guard thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall help thee up in their hands. Yes, thou shalt have to be this too. Thou shalt tread upon the lion. And if the young child and the young woman shall have something about it, because they have set the Lord upon them, therefore I like to be mine. I will set it on high, because I have known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With one eye, will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. So shall we be for all of us and our families in the name of Jesus. For you and I, not to lose, we have to be under the shadow of our lives. Number two, for you and I, not to lose, we have to be spiritually alert. We have to be spiritually alert. Number three, for you and I, to lose. We have to watch the guidance that we go. Not all guidance are good. There are some guidance that when we go, they rob people of their destiny. And they keep them in bondage. So we have to remind them of the guidance we go. For us to lose, we must be prayerful. We must be prayerful. For us not to lose, we must be mindful of it. Because it is the word of God that is power. For us not to lose, we must guide our thought. Guide your thought. For by thy word, you shall be justified. And by thy word, you shall be condemned. To guide your thought. And lastly, for us to lose, we must be in spirit always. We must be in spirit always. Are you very sad? Maybe you have been lost something. Maybe you have been lost money. You have been lost your glory. Maybe you have been lost your future. You have been lost your destiny. Right away now, God that created you is here. He is here to restore you back in 7th grade. Only you can pray. Only you can cry to the Lord, I need my life to be restored. I want the business of my children to be restored. I want my mind to be restored. I want my future to be restored. I need restoration. Right away, lift up your voice and cry to God. If He wants your life to be restored, say, oh God, my Father. You have not done anything. You have not done. If you have not done something, I remember many days when you were where you had a job. I used to give you this testimony. You used to call me a chairman, One day, just like Job, the job was broken down. It's a good time. It was a good time that I thought I said that I can't cry. But when that thing happened, the third time I cried. The enemies watched and they attacked. But tell you what, I don't want anything to be ever seen for me. I want you to pray. Oh God, what a restoration!
Let there be fire in my mouth. Let there be.
we are blessed.
Amen.
I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Whatever the enemies have planted in your life to cut short your life, such evil plantations by the power of the Lord, they are being removed now.
Amen.
And I will not say that. God is asking the church that from this day on, that whosoever is kept alive in this church, that their lives will become brighter and brighter, shining and shining all the way from life. Thank you, Jesus. See, there is something that is an advantage of being. Doesn't want to say, God is asking you to tell you that He's going to give you the whole world. Father, I can see that. God said He's going to give that person the miracle. And I can see the miracle and say, Lord, Father, I can see you. I decree upon every soul that I hear, as this day is going to happen, you will not die. Your children will not die.
Amen.
I said your children will not die.
Amen.
You will not die back to mourn your loss.
Amen.
Every plan of the enemies to kill you or to kill any members of the family, such plans are very under your control. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, He said. Tell the Lord, God has done it. Tell the Lord, God has done it. Ask the Lord, God has done it.